Solar power. It's clean, it's green, and it's free. Well, sunlight's free. But you do need to invest in the gear. Hi, I'm Matt, and I'm an engineer, and this is Need to Know, where we research the latest developments in technology and break down the important facts in under 5 minutes. So here are three things you need to know about solar panels. The first thing you need to know about solar power is that it's definitely on the rise. Solar is now one of the two least expensive ways for utility companies to generate electricity. The other, by the way, is wind. For homes and non-utility businesses, solar is competitive with other energy sources. The Earth is bathed in 173,000 terawatts of sunlight at any given moment. That's 10,000 times more than everyone on Earth uses in a whole year. And here's the thing. At this very moment, we humans are using solar panels to collect only a fraction of that free energy. The second thing you need to know about solar panels is that there are two kinds, solar thermal and photovoltaic. To the untrained eye, they look pretty much the same. But don't get blinded by the light. Not all solar panels are created equal. Solar thermal panels collect heat. They're great for heating offices, homes, and swimming pools. Photovoltaic panels, or PV panels, are usually what people are referring to when they talk about solar panels. PV panels convert sunlight directly into electricity through the photovoltaic effect, discovered by this guy back in 1839. But the market for solar panels didn't begin to develop until the market for computer chips did. Why is that? It's because the two have a common element. Literally an element, it's silicon. Once semiconductor companies figured out how to mass produce silicon computer chips, it was a hop, skip, and a jump to mass producing solar panels based on silicon PV cells. With computer chips, you can drive down the price by integration, doubling the number of transistors that can fit into the same area of silicon about every couple of years. With solar panels, you can drive down the price by increasing conversion efficiency. For instance, a solar panel built in 1975 could convert roughly 12% of the sunlight that hit it into electricity. Nowadays, the conversion rate of solar panels is better than 22%, which means that modern solar panels can generate roughly double the electricity of their predecessors. That's a huge factor driving down the price of solar energy, and researchers are trying to drive down the price even further by developing materials that are cheaper than silicon or have better conversion efficiencies. Most solar panels are made with polycrystalline silicon. They're the ones that convert about 22% of sunlight. But if you swap out the polycrystalline silicon for monocrystalline silicon, you can improve that to almost 25%. But monocrystalline silicon is more expensive. A growing portion of the market is making solar panels with thin films. Thin films get conversion rates up to only about 18%, but these materials are relatively cheap, flexible, and easy to manufacture. The most popular thin film so far is cadmium telluride, which contains cadmium and tellurium. The downside is that tellurium is very, very rare. Recently, German researchers achieved world records with another kind of solar cell. They use layers of compound semiconductors including gallium indium phosphide, aluminum gallium arsenide, and gallium indium arsenide. The result? They've built cells that can convert nearly 50% of incoming light. While these solar cells are expensive lab experiments at the moment, they are yielding encouraging results for solar power. And finally, the third thing you need to know brings us back to PV solar panels. The hardware setup is relatively straightforward at a high level. If you have multiple PV panels, you'll need a combiner to consolidate the outputs from all the panels into one output. And for safety, you can also have a disconnect that can cut power from the panels to the rest of the system. The sun isn't always shining, so you'll want some batteries to store extra energy for times of darkness. A charge controller handles battery charging and also provides power for DC loads. Most loads will be AC, so an inverter converts the DC electricity into AC for all your electronics. And specialized ruggedized connectors tie it all together. A reputable electronics distributor should have everything you need. And there it is, three things you need to know about solar panels. If you want to dive deeper, check out this article on our website. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and our technical newsletter for more.